Happy Sunday! Are you guys all ready to do some mixed media postcards with me? I have had a fun weekend. How has your weekend been? I hope all you guys are doing good. Got a picture of my crazy arm in the middle of it. Sorry about that. Anyway, I hope you guys are good. You know, I hope you are good. I hope you guys had a good weekend. I hope you have fun. Anyway, so I thought, I told you guys a few days ago that I was going to possibly do something today, and I've got a couple messages, so I hope you guys all join me and come and make along. I'm going to make some mixed media postcards. So, if you guys have collected your junk mail, I have lots of junk mail. I don't know about you guys, but I get a pretty, I'm excited about the amount of junk mail I get. I get junk mail from my friends too. They send me junk mail. And so, it's pretty fun. Say hi, whoever's here. Say hi. So anyway, I'm gonna make some postcards. Hi, Jill. Oh, good. Happy to see you. I hope you have fun at dinner. Good for you. Hi, Nancy. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Today we're gonna make some mixed media postcards out of junk mail. So I don't know if that interests any of you, but that's what I have going on my crafty table. I have some mixed media postcards. I'm going to make some mixed media postcards. So if you guys get any of this sort of junk mail in your, you know, this kind of junk mail postcards, that's what we're going to do. You can make along or craft and make anything you want to make. Oh, I hope you have come back and say, we may be back, but we may still be here when you get back from dinner, Jill. Hi, Sam, you're new. Welcome. Samantha from Oklahoma. Awesome, awesome. Where in Oklahoma, Samantha? I'm from Texas, but I have family that lives in Oklahoma. So if you guys want to make along, all you need to do, and look, you could use other things. You don't have to use junk mail. I've collected a lot of these junk mail postcards, so I'm excited to use them. So if you want to make along, you just need something heavier than just paper. Northeast corner of Oklahoma, awesome. Awesome, awesome. So you just need something like any sort of junk mail. Or, you know, the inserts from a fashion magazine, those work too. You know, the subscription cards. Say hi, everybody. You know, I'm talking about the subscription cards or the heavier pieces of card, heavier pieces of magazine pages, too. That'll work, too. So, just bring along. Or you could also use some cereal box packaging if you want. So, I'm going to just get started. What I started doing is I started painting it. So, that's the first step. The first step in your junk mail in creating your junk mail postcards is to paint over them. Hi, Nancy from Jacksonville, Florida. Where do you live in Jacksonville? I know it very well. Where do you live in Jacksonville, Nancy? Welcome. I'm happy to have you here. Everybody, please say hi. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to paint our junk mail. Now, you can paint it a couple of different ways. I love a jelly plate, but if you don't have a jelly plate, you can just paint it with a paintbrush. You could paint it with your brayer, you know, a rolling brayer. And for those of you that don't know what a brayer is, this is a brayer. The south side of Jacksonville. Awesome. I haven't been to Jacksonville in years, but I used to love, there's some great places in Jacksonville that I love. Like, I've been to Avondale and all those places. I love that part of Jacksonville. So we're going to just start painting our junk mail. And you can use, I end up using cheap acrylic paint. And that's what I do. And you're going to layer over it. So, hi, Anne. Welcome. How's your Sunday going? So I'm going to use my paint palette. You know me, I like coffee lids. You know me, I think I am really a cheap crafter. I really enjoy using in my cup of coffee that I hope I won't stick any paint in. Which one of you girls was telling me the funny story about dipping your paintbrush in your coffee? So I'm just going to paint my junk mail first. And you can paint it any color. How's your Sunday, Anne? Tell me what's going on with you. If you guys haven't joined our Facebook group, go on and join it. It's called Crafting Mamas. And, you know, it's just a really great place. So if you do decide to want to share your artwork, whatever that is, you can do it there. You know, you can share what you make with me. I'm sharing what I'm making with you. So I mixed a little gesso with some acrylic paint. And just because I have a big bowl of gesso right here. But you can paint it in anything. And the idea is you want to just paint your junk mail. I'm going to paint mine. I'm just painting mine with a diaper wipe. Okay, I'm going to do it real, like finger painting with a dried baby wipe. So you just want to block out some of the text. And you can sand it if you want to. You cut out your birds and hearts. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to see them. Some of you guys are really going to town on those birds and hearts. I love making them. Did you see Carla? She's really gone to town. She's made like a ton of birds and hearts. And for those of you that are new, on Fridays for the next few weeks, I've been doing a Christmas in July series, and we've been making all sorts of things that you may want to give as a holiday gift. It could be for a birthday gift too, but we've been making holiday ornaments on Friday. We did the past couple of Fridays, and we're going to make some, I don't know, all kinds of cool stuff. So if you guys want to join in on a Friday live stream, it's a little later than it is now, but that's what we've been doing. So paint one side and let it dry, and then paint the other side. So you want both sides painted. You've been watching your hubby roast coffee. That looked amazing. You know, coffee's my weakness, so I have my cup of coffee here, too. Hi, Lori. Oh, awesome. Well, I'm using junk mail to begin my mixed media, but you can use anything you want. I like to recycle. I'm a recycling, for those of you that don't know me, I'm a big proponent of recycling crafting. Now, I feel like we have so much stuff already, you know, and if I can use something that would have been put, you know, be thrown away or that sort of thing, I go for that first. But you could do the same technique with your scrapbooking paper or watercolor paper or whatever you like. You know, it's not... If there's no rhyme or reason. Hi, Michelle. Hello, ladies. I don't do it as good as you, but. So get your junk mail out or whatever you're going to paint. You could do it on a cereal box. I mean, these I'm going to send out as Happy Mail postcards. That's what I'm doing. Okay, so I'm painting my junk mail. That's what I'm doing first. Painting my junk mail. And... Hi, Bridgeline, how are you? What time is it in England, Bridgeline? Heat gun alert, ladies, heat gun alert. I have the industrial strength heat gun. So tell me what's on your crafty tables, ladies. I want to hear what's on your crafty tables and what you guys are thinking of making and, you know. This is a great way if you really just want to dabble in mixed media, but you don't, maybe you haven't like taken a plunge and bought yourself a lot of supplies or that sort of thing. You can do it with your junk mail. You know, it's just junk mail. You're making it better no matter what. It's midnight in England. Ah, hi, Kayla. How's your Sunday? So I'm just drawing the junk mail. So for those of you that want to join in, just you can grab anything. It just needs to be a little heavier than regular paper, okay? And I am going to... I told you guys I have people save me their junk mail, so I've got it going on. I got my own junk mail. You took the day off today, Michelle? Good for you. Good for you. It's still early in the day where I am. It's only 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So the other things that you're going to need for this type of mixed media that I'm doing is some book pages, magazine pages. You can use some stamps and some ink, or you can make your own stamps. You don't need to buy any. You know, you can use any paper cutout for a stamp if you didn't already know. Now, this is not going to be perfect and it's not going to cover up everything, but it's just starting. I'm making postcards tonight, Kayla, but we're definitely going to make greeting cards. We're definitely going to make some holiday cards with our junk mail. Probably next week I'll get all the stuff together for that. It's similar supply list. You just need some book pages, and you might want to, for your holiday cards, you might want to go ahead and either find a holiday stamp if you want to use a stamp, or create one for yourself, or I don't know. I make it with newspaper, and you're making a mixed media tag, Lori. Awesome. See, you can do the same process with your tags. You do need some paint, though. You know, you can't. It's a little difficult to make your mixed media work without paint. Okay, I think I have enough to start for right now. I'm going to just let that one dry, too. Oh, good for you. You're using old greeting cards? That's a great thing to use. Old greeting cards are great to use. Yeah, if you guys go back and look in my channel a while back, you can see some junk mail Christmas cards that I made, you know? So I just want to dry the paint before I lay it down, so when I lay it down on something, it doesn't stick together. You feel the heat gun all the way in Ohio, Michelle? Oh my gosh. Nancy, you're hoarding magazines? I hoard magazines too. Well, I don't hoard them. I go through them and I make all kinds of stuff. Good for you. You know, magazines are a great supply. Even the ones that you get that are like junk mail ones. Like, I make all kinds of stuff out of my catalogs that I get. Okay, so I like to work on multiples at once. I don't know what you girls want to do, but this is sort of my process, and I'm happy to share it with you. So I kind of already started on this one, and I have a few. Now this one I may end up cutting up to be smaller, so I like to work on more than one at one time. So now you want to get your book pages. If you have some book pages, this is a great way to use your fragile book pages too, ladies. The reason why is because when you use like stuff like this, and I didn't sand it, when you use it, I'm sorry, I have to wipe my hands off. I'm having a little sticky moment here. You want your paint and your inks and stuff to have something to stick to. This is a great way to use fragile book pages. You guys know my crazy story of risque book pages. That's the only thing you want to take consider. So start tearing up your book pages. Lori, you know what? You don't really need a lot of paints. And the thing is, you can use any kind of paint. You can use watercolor. I have super cheap acrylic paint that I'm going to use on this. So just lay some book pages down in areas that it's going to take more layers. So just lay some book pages down, some book text where you like. Hi, Scotty. You're watching from Sonic. Oh, could you bring me, I would like some chili cheese fries from Sonic, please. And I would like one of those slush puppies. Could you bring me that? I want that. I want some chili cheese fries. I haven't been to Sonic in years, you guys. I don't have a Sonic in Hawaii, but I used to go when I lived in Texas. Okay, I use a credit card. This is just a plastic. I don't know where I got it. Somebody was giving it away, like an index card. I'm using glue stick. I like this for my first layer, and I use a permanent glue stick. I don't use a water soluble one, because if you start adding layers upon, hi Lynn, if you start adding layers and layers and layers upon your cards, and you've used a water soluble glue, it's gonna come up if you use any wetness. So I'm just letting you know, okay? So don't worry about it. It may take on an ugly look. All art does before it gets better, okay? So I don't want you guys to like start thinking like yours doesn't look good or whatever. You just want to get some layers down before we start adding more paint to it. How's your baby? How are you feeling, Lynn? And how's your baby? Did anybody cook a big Sunday dinner? Those were always really popular when I was growing up. Like, in my house, my mom and dad and my grandmother, they would cook big, huge Sunday dinners. Do you guys do that? I honestly don't do that here. I used to, but everybody seems to be working on a Sunday here because, as I told you, it gets, it's a busy place here. You know, it's not, we live in a tourist destination, right? So there's really no days off. They're all similar. So all I'm doing right now is I'm just laying some text pages. It's just going to give me some more interest when I start to add more paint. And it can be any kind of paint that you want. Don't think just because you don't have what I have doesn't mean you can't do it. You could also do it with, if you have alcohol inks or sprays, if you have watercolors, you could do that. You could do it with anything. The thing is, you don't want to get it too wet, so even when you use your watercolors, you just want to use it as dry pigment as you can. Oh, the baby's great. Oh, I'm so happy. Oh, no. Now your 14-year-old has it? Oh, my gosh. Lynn, that's horrible. Hi, Carla. Oh, awesome. If you guys don't know Carla, her channel is Caged Fish. And she streams live every Tuesday on Ustream. And Carla, what time is it on Ustream? 2:00 Eastern time? Is that what it is? Is that when you stream? And if you guys want to watch the replay, she posts the replay on YouTube. And she is an amazing, inspirational, I think you're a very amazing, inspirational mixed media artist, Carla. Okay, so I am just, and she does amazing glue books, and you guys go over and check her channel out. You would love it. You'll learn a lot. She shares her process, and it's really awesome. So just get some book pages down, okay? And I don't want you to think about it, because we're not really thinking about composition at this point. What we're thinking about right now is just adding some layers and texture. Yes, 2 p.m. Eastern on Tuesdays. No, you're awesome, and you know what? You're cooking, Carla? Oh, could you send some my way? Because I'm starving right now, but it was so hot today, I just couldn't cook. Maybe I'll cook later when the sun goes down. You guys definitely head over there and check her channel out, though. You will love what she does. She does a lot of really cool stuff. So get your book pages down. It can be book, and then we're going to add some magazine pages, too. You made a book while watching me, Carla? I know, I'm kind of long-winded. Okay, I'm coming over. Fried chicken and mashed potatoes sounds like right up my alley. Yes, and go over and subscribe to her channel, you guys. You will love it. You will love it. You will learn so much. Who is it that came here and said they wanted to learn about mixed media? Head over to Carla's channel. She'll teach you a lot about composition and, I don't know, she's got a very organic way of working that I enjoy a lot. I really enjoy it. And I try to watch her every Tuesday, and then I do watch the recording sometimes if I miss it live. And I craft along too. because I really enjoy it. Hi, Jen. Carla's cooking a big Sunday dinner. Michelle says it's cereal day for her. Michelle, you know, I haven't even had cereal yet. I'm not a big, this is going to sound terrible. I'm usually a one meal a day person. Does that make sense for any of you? And I know I get fussed at all the time that I'm a one meal a day person, but I am. So what I want you guys to do is just get some paper down and realize that these are just postcards. You know, they're going to be Happy Mail postcards. You can't mess them up, all right? Can you repeat after me? You cannot mess it up. You know, so many times I think many of us are just, like, we're scared to try things, new things especially, thinking that we're trying things and we go, oh, well, I might mess it up, or it's not going to be great, or... You know, you've got to start somewhere, all right? So after you get some book pages on one side, then on the other side, does anybody have tissue paper? I'm going to show you what I'm going to do on the other side, okay? I mean, this is dress patterning paper, but, you know, you can use anything you want. But I like dress patterning paper. So I'm going to make multiples at one time, so it's going to get a little bit messy for a little bit. And then after the mess, it'll calm down and you guys will all see the method to my madness. And the reason I like to make multiples at once. Okay, I'm going to use some tacky glue. You can use anything you like. I like tacky glue, and honestly, I like it full strength. I like it full strength. I like it thick. Yeah, I'm a one meal a day person, and people fuss at me. Cereal. Cereal sounds good too, right? You know, Lori, mixed media is, honestly, it's just a way for you to express yourself using layers and layers of materials. So today will be glue and paint and maybe some spray and some collage. And you could add, if you have, I do have texture paste and all that stuff, I just don't have it on my desk today. This is the only day you take off is on Sundays, Michelle? That's good. You know what? I don't know if there's such a thing as a day off in my house right now. But who knows? You never know. Now, I also like to use a credit card, and I have one on my desk here somewhere. I keep one credit card clean, and then I use one for glue. And I'm sorry my desk is so messy, but I've been creating for all day long, and then I've been waiting for... Remember I told you guys that my stove blew up? Well, the guy said he was going to come at some point today and try and work a little bit more on the electrical. Even though it's Sunday, I told you it's like sort of a 7-day-a-week thing here. So, you like messy? Oh, Lynn, you know, I can't craft neat. I try, but I can't. I'm over it now. I used to, like, really make myself crazy trying to be neat, but I can't. Okay, so this is my trick, and you could do this with a paper napkin. Do any of you guys save those layers of paper napkins, the white layer that you don't do anything with? Does anybody save that besides me? Now, I'm working on a recycled top. I use my, I have some plastic underneath it. I use some shelf liner paper, the other side of the shelf liner, the shiny side. I usually keep a painting. I usually keep like a Wine Spectator magazine pages underneath it, but lately I've been gluing so much I haven't. And then I have a piece of wax paper, like kitchen wax paper. So I spread this glue as thin as I can, and I spread it to the end because we're going to add some texture to this page. Okay, and I'm using like a gift card. It actually just was like something that came into the mail. And I'm spreading the glue. And I keep going until it's really thin. I mean, until you can't really even see the layer. You know, you can see the shine, and I go all the way to the end. All the way to the end. This is a great way if you want to use your paper napkins, if you want to use those, you know, like the regular paper, the colorful paper napkins. You could also put down, I'm going to put down tissue paper. I'm putting down the dressmaking tissue paper, but you could also put the tissue paper that you get in gifts, you know, the white tissue paper. You can stamp on it if you wanted to before you lay it down. Colored paper napkins, the white layer of paper napkins. What I'm doing is I'm going to build some texture on this side of my postcard. And what I like about this, when you're making mixed media postcards, is say you don't like it when it ends, right? It's still thin enough that you could take a template to it and cut it up and use it for embellishments. Say you don't like it at the end. Say it's too busy or whatever. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but sometimes I make work and I'm like, oh, I'm not crazy about that. Or my taste change, or the colors didn't come out the way I want. I haven't wasted any expensive materials, and I can still use it as a component in another project. Okay? So, I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this dressmaking paper. It is a big postcard. You know, when you get them in the mail, it is a big one. And you can cut it up, too. Yeah, I stamp patterns on them too. I think it's a great way. So Carla's sharing that she likes to stamp patterns on the white part of your napkins. So I'm crumpling up my paper, my pattern paper, my dressmaking pattern paper. And I'm going to, just to give it a little, and I'm going to lay it down. Okay, it doesn't matter. Don't get all worried. And I'm going to start from the center. And I'm not trying to get all of the wrinkles out, you know. I wanted to add texture. So I'm starting at the center of my postcard, and I'm working out with my plastic credit card to try and adhere it, okay? And it's going to have, mine's going to have big wrinkles in it. Now, if you wanted to do a paper napkin, you obviously would have crumpled it up before you did it if you wanted it to lay down flat if you don't like this texture. But I like the texture. I'm going for some texture here. I'm going for some texture. Hey, Susan. What kind of groceries did you get? Can you go grocery shopping for me? You guys know my little one is still out of town, and I haven't gone grocery shopping. You know, with her away, we've been salading it. We've been having salads. Obviously, she's 10, so she wouldn't want to eat salad every day, but it's been so hot here. Salad's been good for me. So, this is going to overlap a little, and that's fine. You guys, get over the perfection and just get on with the process of it, because I'm going to tell you, once you start finding a process that you enjoy doing, you can make it beautiful, you know, but you got to just get over the initial... Oh, it's not beautiful. All right. This is just texture on one side. All right. So on one side, I've got some paint and book pages. And on this side, I have my pattern paper. All right. And I'm going to let it dry. I'm going to let this one dry for a little bit. It's definitely got some. And I'm going to do another one. Let me find another one that I... These are really big postcards, but this is just what I got in the mail, so I can't really say much. You're making $1 million spaghetti? I don't even know what $1 million spaghetti is. You have to tell us what that is. It sounds amazing. $1 million spaghetti. So maybe I'm only going to do half of this one. I don't know. We'll see. Maybe I'll texture half. Now realize, you guys, I'm going to paint over it. I'm going to paint over it. I may spray over it. I may paint over it. I might leave it. I don't know. So just spread your glue as thin as you can get it. Try to make sure you go all the way to the end. It's kind of hard to go back and re-glue your ends once you've laid your tissue paper down. I have never had $1 million spaghetti. It sounds amazing. Sounds really, really good. Now, this is a great way if you guys are going on vacation and you collect travel brochures or stuff when you're out, you know. Okay, $1 million spaghetti is, oh wow, cream cheese, sour cream, cottage cheese, mozzarella, cheddar, and parmesan. Woo! That definitely does sound like $1 million spaghetti. Good for you. It sounds yum. If I ate it, I probably would have to go to sleep right after. Okay, so I'm just going to do similar what I did earlier. I'm going to lay down my tissue, and then I'm going to start spreading from the middle out. And I'm not trying to get the wrinkles out. I'm just trying to add some texture to my page. You know, postcards are not like a canvas. So if you're making a mixed media canvas, you can add a lot more stuff to it. You know, I also want to mail this. I want to make it a functional postcard. You know, so I want to stick it in the mail. So I'm not going to add like super thick layers, but just some layering techniques. But it sounds like an Alfredo sauce. Oh, it sounds so good. Don't you think everybody's cooking tastes better when somebody else cooks for you? I was talking about that earlier today with a friend. We're talking about how everybody else's cooking tastes better when somebody else cooks for you. What do you guys think? And do any of your kids cook? One of my kids is an amazing cook, and the other daughter, she really was never interested in learning to cook. Now, granted, she's only 19. But the other day she said to me, I was telling her, she was asking me what I was going to cook this week. And I said, I don't know. What do you want? You know, what do you have in mind? And she was like giving me some input. And then she says, I think I want to hang out when you cook. I said, oh, really? And she said, yeah, I'm kind of tired of not really knowing how to cook. She was never interested when she was younger. My oldest daughter, she was always interested. I think she's been cooking since she was like little, 9 or 10, like really reading recipes and trying to follow them. Now, I'm only trying to make sure the ends and everything are down, because once you start adding things, I just don't want it to come up. Carla makes amazing meander book, and we used to call them a Jacob's Ladder book. Did you ever call them that, Carla? A Jacob's Ladder book? We called them that when I was growing up. We called them a Jacob's Ladder book. She does make an amazing meander book. She collages in them too. So they're awesome. Her meander books are awesome. So I'm just pulling off the tissue paper, the dressmaking paper. Lynn saying her daughter will bake but won't touch meat or fish. Well, yes, Jacob's Ladder. But we used to call meander book a Jacob's Ladder book. You didn't call that, you know, the ones that opened every which way. You didn't call it that. I like them. I think they're awesome. If you guys want to learn how to make one, go over to her channel. You said you're making one on, are you making one on Tuesday on your live stream? Is that what you're making on Tuesday on your live stream, Carla? Yeah, the meander one does go in all directions, but I like them. I think they're awesome. I've made a few. I used to make them as greeting cards. Have you ever made them like that? Like, I used to make them sort of like Christmas or birthday cards or stuff like that. You wanted to give people and write like sentiments into them. Okay, I have these two. This one looks like I think it's dry. I'm going to let this in dry. You guys go over and check it. Susan says to her, they're fiddle books. They are fiddle books, but you know what I love about making books? There's something so rewarding about finishing a book. Do you guys feel that way? Like especially if there's just something rewarding about it. Your son makes great salmon. Oh my gosh, that's awesome. You guys head over to Carla's channel, though. She's been doing what's it called? The Everything Book or the Anything Book? Is that what it's called? I loved it. I watched you last week. My Ustream has been acting up. Like, every time I try to comment, it just, I don't know. Okay, so this one's dry a little bit, and I'm going to take some of this gesso before it completely dries up, this gesso acrylic paint mixture, and I'm going to just paint a little on here. Now you can you guys see the texture better now? Yeah, Carla's doing an anything goes book. Oh, you're doing a scrapbook store sample? Awesome. Well, Carla, you'll have to tell us where you're teaching, because I bet you a bunch of our YouTube viewers live near you and they should come and take a class. They would probably really love it. I would love it if I lived close enough to Florida, sister, I'd be able to take a class with you. I live in the middle of nowhere. Yeah, you guys go watch her Anything Goes book. It is amazing. I have to tell you, Carla, for whatever reason, my internet wasn't working good last week. Okay, so if you guys have some sprays, now's the time. So one side has got some book pages, and this side has got your texture. Yeah, when you do a meander book, I want to do it with you. I would love to do one again. I did one a while back when you did one. I'm just going to use some spray inks. You guys can use, if you had, I love these. I'm in love with these. You guys know I am, these Lindy Stardust sprays. But there's also lots of Tattered Angel sprays that are good. Just some cool stuff. So I like these sprays, but I just wanted you to see how the texture, can you guys see how the texture is starting to really show up when you put something light and dark with it? Can you guys see? And I'm beginning to really like it. So you guys know me, I've got to have like a little texture on everything. I can't not have texture. I don't know what color this is. I got these sprays, and some of them I got them all at one time. They were on sale, as everybody knows, and I mixed all of them up. I finally mixed all of them up, and I don't know all the colors. It kind of does look like stucco. You're absolutely right, it does, but it's just a little piece of paper, right? So, and I know I said it's a postcard. You know, I do want to send it in the mail. What I may do is put it in an envelope. Because sometimes I really like, it looks like the mountains. Yeah, kind of. You're right, it does. But what I like is, hi, Kiki. Welcome. Where are you from, Kiki? What I like about when you make these mixed media postcards is, you know, you're making like small little pieces of artwork. And yes, you could send it in the mail as a postcard, which I might, depending upon what I do on the other side. But I may make an envelope and send it in an envelope. All right, bye, Carla. Big hugs, and we'll see you on Tuesday. You guys head over to her channel on Tuesday. Making fried chicken is hard anyway, even if you're not doing this sort of thing. Well, I'm liking it so far. What do you guys think? Columbus, Ohio. We have a bunch of Ohioans. Is it Ohioan in the house? Bye, Carla. See you Tuesday. You guys make sure you go check her channel out. You'll be really into it. She's really an amazing artist. And she's very giving and generous with her information and time. I think maybe I'm going to use a little of this wet glue. I don't usually use wet glue, but I'm going to on this. Because it's going to be laying over texture. Hi, Pamela. Pamela lives in Melbourne, Florida. You guys tell everybody where you're from. What's super cool is, like, in our Friday live stream, we had two ladies from South Africa, and they didn't know each other before the live stream, and then they find out that they live, like, really close, and they're going to get together and craft. Isn't that cool? They live really close to each other, and then they... So just start adding layers of stuff that you like. I don't think I'm going to look through some magazines, I think. And so the reason I work on multiples at one time It's because then I can't really think about it. You know, I'm not caught up in my thoughts as much as I'm caught up in the getting stuff glued down, and I like the way it comes out. She does great collages, Carla. She's amazing. And you know what? She's really incredibly generous with her energy and her spirit, and she is just, and she's very encouraging. So, you know, you guys know me well enough to know I'm all about that. Kiki says she's met two sister crafters in her area. Awesome. We were talking about that too last week, or one day on one of the live streams. We were talking about how you meet your crafty best friend. And I've met my crafty best. I have a couple of crafty besties that I've met on YouTube and on, you know, from being on YouTube and from moving my pages around, you guys. So I do like to work on multiples, and I like to work on multiples because then I'm not overthinking it. Do any of you have that same issue where you can overthink your stuff? Does anybody have that except for me? Where you can really like start overthinking like the whole process, you overthink what you're doing, you overthink how it's looking, then you start being really critical. I mean, you know, I find when I just get into the zen of doing it, and I do multiples at once. That's why, like, when I make, like, tags, you guys watch me in my crazy tag compilations, I just go for it. I'm, like, doing them all at once. I don't know what color these are going to be, but, and it may not be any of these colors that I have here. It may end up being something totally different. Awesome. Winchester, Kentucky, that's great. Awesome. Yeah, if you haven't joined our Facebook group, go on over and join it. It's like there's no time like the present, and everyone is very, very nice there. Everyone is super nice. And so have you guys watched any of my Paint Your Junk Mail series? You know me, I love to paint my junk mail. And so I have some junk mail I'm going to add to my... I'm going to add some junk mail to this. Oh, you overthink your stuff every single moment. Good night, Bridgeline. See you. Maybe I'll see you Friday. We'll be on Tuesday and we'll be on Friday. I overthink things all the time, too. You know, I'm going to tell you, if you jump in, Pam, and you make these, like, ridiculous postcards and tags and different stuff like that, and you just go for it, you will find, little by little, you will be letting go of whatever your preconceived notions are of art, and you can start to really have fun with it, you know? Like, I paint my junk mail, and that is very zen for me, because it's junk mail, and I paint it, and I spray it, and Hi, Nancy. Thanks for joining us. Okay, all you lurkers out there, say hi. All you gotta do is say hi. You lurkers, say hi. Say, I'm out here. Do any of you get these little Reader's Digest things? I get them sometimes that are where we recycle. They just have them there, so I just wanted to see if there was any... anything that I want out of it. I like this wet. What? Sometimes I save letters. Do you guys save letters too? I save letters. Hi, Kathy. You know, Pam, you just gotta keep going. You know, I find for myself that if I just keep working on stuff, there's gonna be obviously some things that you like better than others. That's just the nature of it, okay? So there's gonna be stuff that you like better than others. So you just gotta keep trying. You just gotta keep trying. Yep. Say hi to each other, everybody. Say hey. Who's lurking out there? Who is lurking? If you guys haven't made my magazine accordion file folder yet, I say do it. It's really super fun, but more than that, it gives you a place to store all the bits and pieces of stuff that you collect. So if you haven't gone over and made one, do it. I just want some images and I don't know. I want something different. Do you guys ever do that? Where you want something different? This is perfect. What do I want? That's so me. Oh, I like this girl. Night, lady. See you later, Michelle. Go have a wonderful evening. Happy congratulations on taking the day off. We all need to do that for ourselves all the time. Self-care, and more self-care, right? I don't know what it is about us ladies. We don't take care of ourselves. Okay, I'm gonna let that one go. Sorry, my hands are so dirty. I don't have any. Usually I come here with a really wet towel, but I didn't today. Hi, Bet. Yes, Scotty, how's your cat? Okay, all you lurkers out there, come in and say hey. Hey, Sue. Welcome, Sue. Where are you from? Bet, don't worry about the misspelling. Can I tell you? I would tell you guys my autocorrect story, but it's so not PC that I would probably get thrown off of YouTube for it. My friend's mother's autocorrect story. It's like, oh please. So I use all kinds of magazines for my stuff. Do you guys do that too, or is it just me? Just so you know, all of you lurking in the back, we can't see you. So when you say hi, we just know you're here. Oh, I think I like this shark. Lurkers! Hello, lurkers! Who is lurking? Okay, these are going to be on my postcards today, I think. Oh, I like the colors in that too. So they have some cool stuff sometimes, you know? I know a lot of people harvest their magazines. I do and I don't. Like sometimes I just keep it all in there and I just keep the magazine. Because sometimes I look through it once. I mean, sometimes I do. Depends upon if I'm working on a project. Now you can make these mixed media postcards out of these too. I love making them out of this. Does anybody besides me make them out of this? We don't bite. We really don't. So, if any of you, I keep my post. A lot of people harvest their harvest their magazines, and I do. I mean, I have boxes of images, and I have boxes of words, but then sometimes, for me, I can flip through it, and in the moment, like right now, I have a stack that I really don't harvest. Like some of these, you'll see the bits are cut out of it. Because I've used it, but I keep them together. Because I don't know why, you guys. I like it like that. I'm silly, right? And I may not use. Oh, look, I could have. If I was sending you this to you, Susan, I could put cookies on it, right? Who besides Susan is addicted to cookies? Susan told me she made brownies yesterday. I was like, please send some my way. You know what, Kiki, I can guarantee you all you have to do is ask a neighbor and say, could I have one of your magazines? Or go to a place where you guys recycle. There'll be all kinds of There's always people recycling. Or if you go to the doctor's office, they'll often, you know, throw away magazines after a while. And right now I'm just looking, I'm not looking for any focal images. I'm just looking for sort of textures. Like, I'll give you for instance, like I'm looking for textures for what I'm going to put on here. And I may paint on top of it, but see, don't you love that polka dotted texture? I like that. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to use the polka dotted texture. I really like that. I also like the top part where it's got like some sort of crossbar on it. Super subtle. But this is just me. This is how I do it. You don't have to do it my way. Do find yours and do it your way. Now, some people really love just harvesting images, and I think that's great too, but for me, I would rather, I do. I have some that are harvested, and then I have some that I leave. Okay, that's a good background. I like this one too. Recyclebank.com for free magazines. Oh, very good. I didn't even know about that. Your brother lived in Victor and he now lives in Buna. Wow. In Buna, Texas? Is that what you're talking about, Sue? Vider? You know what? I'm from that. My dad. Please. Can I tell you? I think my dad was born in Buna. Is that ridiculous? That's like the middle of nowhere, Texas. Like you have to drive far to get to there. Let me see. This one's got some browns and this has got good color on it. Let's see. Isn't that crazy? It's a small world too. It's a small world. It's a small world. We're talking about places in Texas. I'm originally from Texas. And Susan and Bette live in Texas. Where do you live, Sue? You live in Texas too? Now, use glue stick, ladies. I'm using permanent glue stick. So I'm going to color paint over it. You live in Texas too? Good for you. Most of my family still lives in Texas. The only people that don't are me and my sister. My sister lives in the Carolinas, and I live here in Hawaii. So the rest of our family all lives in Texas. So don't worry sometimes if you get this down and you go, oh, that's too bright. That wasn't the color palette I was going for. You can always tone it down. Always, always, always tone it down. I think I may add some texture to this page. You live in Beaumont? I love Beaumont. Beaumont has like, oh my gosh, what's the name of that great breakfast place in Beaumont? It was in Beaumont. Can't even remember, not that long ago, and I ate at the most amazing. I remember eating there with my sister. He'll come to me in a minute. But you know what I'm talking about. It's like right in downtown Beaumont. And the food's excellent. They have like some of the best pancakes I've ever had. People come from all over for their biscuits and pancakes there. I don't know. I've been talking a lot about food lately, so there you go. Okay, girls. How many of you girls are making along with me, or how many of you just hanging out lurking? It doesn't matter. You don't have to make along with me. You can hang out and lurk. Lurking is good, too. Lurking is good, too. I just want some texture on the front of this, a little bit more texture, so that when I finally do finish painting it all, it'll be good. It is a small world. So you could use your tissue paper the same way, ladies. You don't have to, if you don't have this dressmaking pattern paper, you could use tissue paper. I'm gonna let it dry and then I'm gonna work on the back. You know what? It'll come to me. I'll ask my sister in the next live stream, I'll tell you. Our dad is from that area up near there, and so we still, when we would drive through, you know, because you fly into Houston and you're watching and cutting Ann, awesome. You're just looking, you can lurk, Nancy. Sometimes I lurk too. Yes, we have a Facebook group, and it's called Crafting Mamas. So join, please join me. We'd love to have you there. We'd love to hang out with you and get to know you better. Okay, I want you guys just to think about, like, it's not about making it perfect, okay? I'm sorry, guys, my neighbors are coming home, so whenever my neighbors come home, so my neighbor was having a yard sale today, and the dog, every single time a car drove up, even though, because it was two doors down, they kept barking. Sorry, guys, she doesn't know any better. Okay, so I'm kind of liking this, and I'm going to paint a little bit. I'm going to do a little texture. I'm going to put a little gesso going over the texture. As you said, over the stucco. Who was it said it looked like stucco? And I'm going to do some over a little bit of the magazine edges too, because they're a little rough. So the idea for me in making these mixed media postcards is that, you know, you start to layer your stuff, and then, you know, as you go, okay, I like that, I don't like that, I want to add this, I don't want to add that, you know, you kind of figure it out as you go along. Hi, Ann. Well, we're happy that you dropped by. Yeah, I do live streams a couple times a week, usually on Tuesdays and Fridays, but today was just an extra day. I said I was going to be making some postcards, so for those of you that haven't tried these spray, haven't had a chance to try spray inks and spray stuff, do it. You'll really find it fun. I find it a lot of fun, and you know, I like the way they come out. Like they develop a cool looking. I have like a little box of it here, right here. I tried to clean off my desk. I've been painting so much and doing some stuff and got a lot of stuff going on. It's just a great way to add a really quick pop of color without too much commitment. Does that make sense? Without too much commitment. A great way to add like a little bit of color. Well, we're happy that you're here. Yeah, it does look a little bit like stucco. I agree. Hey, Carla. Well, we're happy that you joined us, and your birds are coming out amazing. I love your birds and hearts. You're way ahead of me, sister. You got it going on. I've got a lot more to do. Guys, I'm going to use my heat gun so that I can dry it quicker. And I have the industrial strength heat gun. Please don't get one like this. You can actually peel paint off with it. Peel paint off with it. You're working on your birds now? Oh my gosh, they're awesome. I love the red one that you did. Is that watercolor paper that you used? Or what was it that you used? I loved it. You did a great job. You did a great job. I liked it a lot. Okay. So I'm going to put this one over here and I'm going to keep going. The only thing about these Scott brand glue sticks is you have to put the lid on them in between using them. I've kind of learned the hard way. I'm partial to my Uhu glue, but they were having a sale on these, and so I bought them, which they're still good, but they dry out if you leave it open. I just wanted to see what color this was. Guys, I made so many of these spray inks that in these blue bottles that I don't know what colors they are. And if you haven't used spray ink, I tell you, try it. You'll really like it. You can make your own, or you can buy them. You made a spray out of coffee and food coloring. It works great too. I agree. You can make it out of anything. You don't have to just make it out of what I'm doing. But I have an idea of how I want it to look, and it hasn't quite gotten there yet. So we'll see how it works out if it does. You know, the thing is that you can make your own, which you can make them as she said, she's made hers out of coffee. You can also make them out of just plain pigment. These are made with water. These are acrylic pigments. These are Lindy's stamp sprays, or what are they called? They're by Lindy's Stamp Gang, and they're called Starburst. That one's called Starburst, and this one's called, I don't know, they're sprays. So I like those too. Those are with water. And then, these are Tattered Angels Glimmer Mist, which I like because they have like a shine and a shimmer to them. So do the Lindy's Stamp Gang. They have a little bit of a mica shimmer to them too. But I like it. I'm just trying to get the drips to go down so that it makes a drippy look. So it just adds another layer of what I'm doing. What are you guys ready? Yeah, what color? Beth's asking, what color food colorings did you use, Anne? What color food colorings did you use? I'm going to spray it till it gets a little bit. I'm going to spray it and get it dry. You know what's fun about once you start working like this is you start seeing everything as an art supply. Do you guys not start seeing everything as an art supply? You start seeing your food coloring. You start seeing your, all kinds of stuff. You start seeing it as an art supply. And I love that because then you don't feel like you have to go out and buy anything, right? You don't have to go out and buy anything. That you already have everything that you need. And you can make these really easy. You can make it with food coloring, you can buy a bottle of rubbing alcohol and use it. You can make it with water. I mean, with alcohol, it dries faster and it doesn't, it doesn't wet you to, it evaporates, so it doesn't absorb on your page so much. But, it's up to you what you like. It's not, there's no rule to it. I like these Lindy's Stamp Gang ones. And as you guys know, I got them when they were on sale. So if you look around or you guys have craft stores where you are, you can maybe get them when they're, you can maybe get them when they're on sale or you have one of those crazy coupons. from your crafting store. So I'm just letting the pigment run down. You can get mica and shiny eyeshadow from the Dollar Tree, somebody told me. I haven't had any, we don't have one here. You can also make that same sort of spray in if you use your coffee, and you can use it with coffee and mix it with coffee and a little water and then mix some alcohol with it. Like, you know, until you get your coffee, like the shade you want, and mix it with alcohol, and then it dries super fast. Or instant coffee and alcohol. And that works as an alcohol spray too. Food coloring and alcohol, Easter egg dye and alcohol. Alcohol, stamp pad inks and alcohol, you know, the stamp pads that, stamp pad refills, you know, the re-inkers and alcohol. You can also do it with Sharpie markers if you take the insides of the Sharpie markers out. Even if you think your markers are dried out, if you soak them in alcohol, put them in little bottles and soak them in alcohol, then, they make really beautiful pigments too. I'm really liking the way this one's looking. What do you guys think? Need some papers coming up on this side. So Anne's saying she made sprays from metallic craft paints and water. Awesome. You just have to shake them up each time? That's great. Yes, I was telling you guys about how my fingers were so black and blue the other day because of the... I was making alcohol inks, or I was using alcohol inks, and I went somewhere I couldn't, and it really looked crazy. I thought you couldn't get, it looked like I had something wrong with my fingers. Okay, I'm liking this one. I'm liking this one. Okay, I have these two I'm liking. I'm going to put my inks up over here and just lay these out and see what the next step is. I have this big purple one that I haven't even started yet, and then I have this one that I started. Okay, and I tore out some pages. Let's see if I can find uses for the pages that I've torn out. And let's see. And then I have some that I have just painted backgrounds on. Yes, instant. Don't use the good stuff, right? Instant coffee, yes. Sharpies, you must cut the plastic that covers the ink felt. Yes, you do. Or you can just cut it open and stick it in. Oh, Susan's saying she heard that you can make a Finnabar Art Alchemy. She heard you can make the Finnabar Art Alchemy with acrylic paint mixed with Walmart Mother of Pearl Medium. Oh, very nice. I haven't tried that. That would be awesome. That would be really awesome. I would try that. Okay, so this is my process so far. This is what I have so far. I have these three. Now I just need to get some, I need to cut up some bits and put it on there. And decide what I'm going to do, what colors are going to do. I'm loving this one already. I like the red in there and that. What do you guys think? Do you guys like this one? I'm liking this one already. I'm liking it a lot. I need some work on it, but I'm liking it. Hi, Diana. You're weeding a flower bed? Oh. Okay. I need to figure out what I'm going to add to it. It's not totally dry, but it's kind of getting there. Okay, let's see. Art Alchemy is really fun. I like that. Good for you. I was testing out my spray inks on this, but I like this little green blob, so I might go ahead and glue it down. And something. I got my pages and my papers, and I got all kinds of stuff. What do you guys have on your crafty desk? I have a crafty mess on my crafty desk. That's just how it rolls in my world. I can start out with a clean slate and it just doesn't stay. Is that anybody else? Is that anyone else? Is it just me? I start out with a clean slate and then it just doesn't last. It doesn't matter what I do. I could have like the neatest desk on the planet and then it shifts. Like it takes like a second, like a real second, and that's it. And that's all it takes. And then it's a done deal. Like, sorry guys, I'm just painting my tips. I'm painting the tips of where I tore the paper. So I want to add this to this postcard, but I don't know where I'm going to add it. I don't know what color I want it to be with. Maybe here. You guys are missing it. What did you say? Yes, you can use Kool-Aid. Kool-Aid works good too. Kool-Aid works really good. Kool-Aid's a great, you can make all kinds of spray inks with Kool-Aid. I don't know, you guys. I get partial to like a color palette and then I think it's almost like eating, you know, I get partial to it for a little bit and then I'm like, okay, now I'm ready to move on to something else. Do you guys ever get like that or is that just me? The one thing is if you've textured your paper, you definitely need to burnish it down really, your whatever you're laying on top of it, burnish it down well. Not so much that you're going to, you know, break the paper, but if it's got texture underneath it, you want it to stick. So you just keep layering until you get a look you like, you know, and it may take a while. I mean, it may not be a fast process. It may take a little bit. You may go, oh, I like that, or I don't like that, or that needs something more. And, you know, I've got three of these going on, or I've got multiples, even more than three on my desk, but three going on at once, and, you know, I haven't reached the happiness yet, the happy point yet. My workspace is smaller and smaller right now, Diana. You know why? Because they're doing that electrical work on our house. It is, I'm kind of scrunched on top of myself at the moment because they've ripped out the wall behind me where I usually spread out, but you're right. So I have this on my desk as opposed to somewhere else, and it does feel smaller. I mean, I could put the box of paint down on the floor, but I don't know. It is smaller though, Diana. Tell Josh. Good eye, Josh. Good eye. Good eye. Good eye. It is. It feels smaller, at least right now. And I think part of it is because of the, it is because of all the stuff behind me. I mean, normally I have a little table that I sit next to me and I put my stuff out on, but I can't even do it right now because of the electrical work going on. But hopefully that'll be done soon. No, I'm serious. It is smaller. You're absolutely right. I mean, it's like true. It's the truth. That's why when somebody complains that they don't have a big craft room, one day I'm going to show you guys mine. When they put the wall back together, I will. Right now, it's like, I don't even want to see it, if you know what I mean. Right now, I'm not even loving it because it's like so cramped. I can't live with it. But I'm doing my best. I'm trying to live with it at the moment. You guys keep layering until you like it. And you may not like it. You may have to like go, oh, I'm going to start over there or whatever. And that's okay. It's just a postcard. It is just a postcard. It is not... You may not like it. I mean, sometimes I make stuff and I'm like, oh. And then I have to go back and mess with it until I like it. It takes a while. And that's okay. Diana, you're absolutely right. It is right now. It's just, I can't even tell you. Right now I'm in my own, like, I'm lucky I have even continued crafting because I could have just thrown in the towel with all the stuff I've got going on, but I didn't. Hi, Liz! You're gluing on a AAA reply card? Girl, you know me. I like my trash. Now, for those of you that are new to mixed media, you don't have to use trash. You can use scrapbook paper. You can use anything you want. You know, the idea is really just to find your freedom and your zen and your joy and your creativity. Okay? So I don't want to hear one of you guys say, oh, well, Shelly says you have to use trash. That's just what I like to use. Okay? I prefer to use recycled materials. I live on an island and I prefer to use recycled materials because when I use recycled materials, you know, it was going to be put in a landfill here anyway, or how, you know, whatever they do with it. I like to use like the cardboard and the different stuff. Now my space is so much smaller right now. I've stressed myself out a little bit. I'm not going to tell you a story. I've stressed myself out a little bit with trying to, first of all, you know, like I was reorganizing everything, which is always great. But then if you add on top of that reorganization, my electrical issue, the electrical problem. And then on top of that, I had to, anyway. And then moving all of it away, it's ridiculous. You know me, I can't do it like simple. I can't do it simple. I gotta make it frustrating for myself. Cause whose life would it be if it wasn't whose life would be so uneventful, you know? Okay, you gotta like what you create, so you keep working on it until you like it. Okay? But I'm liking it so far. You guys are so funny. I want words, but I don't have my word folder nearby. But I do have all those birds and stuff I made. I could put some of those on here. Now, if you were going to do this on a canvas, you might want to go next to a texture paste. But because this is a card and it's thin and I'm going to stick it in the mail, I don't think I'm going to put texture paste on it. But I'm liking them so far. What do you guys think? What are you talking about? So I was talking to Susan Z earlier, and I was telling her, I don't know how we got into talking about this. Oh, she was telling me that she got some wallpaper samples. And I was telling her, I was going to tell you guys my wallpaper sample story. Okay, you ready? So, it's happened to me twice, okay? Once with fabric samples, and the other one with wallpaper samples. So, I'm just contemplating what I'm going to put on here next. So I'm always looking, and where I live on the island of Maui, we have a huge, a lot of people move off and on. It's like a whole ridiculous long story, and it's not really worth talking about that part of it right at this moment, but people move off and on this island really quickly. Island living isn't for everyone. It always sounds romantic, and when you come here on vacation, it's really romantic, but when you live here, you live on an island, you guys. So living on an island isn't for everyone. I mean, it's just not. And it's okay to figure out that it's not just not for everyone. So people, as I said, people move off and on all the time. This was just the mess on my desk, and I'm just going through my bits and pieces of stuff I painted. So looking to see if I see something I want to put on here. I like these Japanese words, but I don't know. That color palette doesn't go really well. It might go on the, I could put it on the opposite side of this. Anyway, so I see with the fabric samples, I see somebody, a lady here put a notification. Oh, I like that. A lady here put a notification on Craigslist. She had maybe, I don't know, 5 or 10 fabric sample books. And at the time I was making, I belonged to a textile. I still belong to them. I just don't swap anymore. But, or very often. There was a textile group on Facebook that, you know, when you would make all kinds of different things. I mean, all sorts of stuff you would make. And it got to be where I was, you know, I live on an island, so I was kind of sick of swapping. I was kind of sick of working with Hawaiian fabric. That's really what there is here, you know? And so when I saw this textile fabric, these fabric sample books, I was all excited. I was like, oh, great. So I called the lady, or I text her, I think, and I say, I'm interested in your sample books, and she said, there's one catch. You have to take it all. And she was kind of a little bit misleading, because she was like, you have to take it all. I said, no problem, because in the picture, she didn't say any more than that. Like, she didn't say there's anything. She just said, you have to take it all. But in the picture, there was, I don't know, like 10 books, I think, or maybe less. So then I drag my daughter, my 10-year-old, which she was a little bit younger then, down to, you guys, I save all these bits. Isn't that ridiculous? But I do. I mean, I do periodically go through, and if you guys haven't watched my Serendipity paper, you can use all these tiny bits for that, but I do save a lot of bits and pieces. This is just what was on my desk from the past couple of days. So I'm just trying to see if there's anything in here I want to use. Anyway, so I drive, and it's not close by my house. I drive over to pick up the textiles, and I walk into the, you know, it's kind of far away, and I walk into the place where she has her stuff, and I say, oh, cool, you know, and it was exactly the picture of what I'd seen. So I was like, oh, great. And she goes, let me help you take them to the car. I'm like, all right. And next thing I know, her assistant comes out. And I have kind of a decent-sized car. I mean, I have a little Toyota RAV4, so the seats pull down in the back. But I'm thinking, oh, that's, you guys, she had like 300 books of textiles. My whole car was filled up. It was ridiculous. It was like, so needless to say, I have 300. So I have shelves in my garage that house huge amounts of textile sample books. So fast forward to like, I don't know, maybe 6 or 8 months later. And I have been telling my partner that I wanted, I wanted some wallpaper sample books, and that I hadn't been able to find any. And he calls me up one day, and he goes, because I happened to be wherever he was going, and he goes, and I saw, ran into somebody, and they were asking me what you were doing or whatever. And anyway, he started talking to them, and he imparted the information that I wanted some wallpaper sample books. And they said, oh, well, call this person that they were just over there. It was at the time he was working on high-end interiors. And so I had said to him, maybe he could ask one of the people he worked with, you know, like one of the girls there. He was doing some carpet, some high-end refinishing work on you know, really expensive houses here. So he goes, he calls me up and he goes, oh, I think I found you some wallpaper sample books, but you have to go pick them up. He goes, but the deal is you have to take them all. And I said, oh, please don't tell me it's like that fabric sample book. He goes, oh, no. I ask him and the guy says that maybe there's 10. I'm like, oh, cool. I said, great. Well, I go down there. There were 10 boxes full. Not 10. 10 boxes full. Told him he missed one. So, needless to say, I think I have more textile sample books than I do wallpaper sample books, but I have quite a few. So that's how I roll, you guys. I can't just have like a couple of something. I gotta have 10 of them, 10 whole boxes. So. Isn't that ridiculous? Are you guys laughing at me now because of my ridiculousness? So, you know, go with it, you guys. Don't even, like, don't criticize or look at your thing and think, oh, it has to be a certain way. Just keep going with it until you're happy with it, okay? Keep going with it until you're happy with it. I don't know what I'm going to do with that shark, but I like it. Keep going with it until you're happy with it. Yes, it was a big score, but so now you see, like, when I clean out my craft space behind me, part of it was those wallpaper sample books. So in my you can't even get into my garage right now. It's like a carport anyway. It's not really a garage. You can't even really get in it. It's like so packed full of stuff. And, you know, it's like, you guys, that's just how it works for me. I'm sorry, but it does. It's like feast or famine. It's like either I have none or I have like 20 million things. Now, if I could channel that same energy into money, that would be good, right? Okay, I want some colors here. I don't know what, though. And I like this green. So, you know, the idea, at least the way I work, and you can do your own mixed media any way you want. So you layer, you get your layers the way you like them. And then if you wanted to add some... If you wanted to add some layers of texture paste, you could do that. You could do that now if you wanted, right? But for me, because they're postcards, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to add any texture paste to my postcards. I guess I could. Let's just see how far I get. When I get it to a place I like and then I want to add some texture to it, I will. Gotta work with it a little bit. Nothing's jumped out at me. I kind of like that, but I kind of don't. I like this, but it doesn't really. Maybe I'll go on this one. What are you guys talking about? Calamari clean out? Oh my god. Yes. The calamari clean out. Yes. You guys, I'm telling you. Have you guys had a good weekend? I want to hear what you guys have done so far this weekend. Guys, I had so many things I really needed to get done, and I didn't do any of it. Made some art, though. Made art. That is what I did. I did not get any of the other stuff done. And I really wanted to. It was like I had... Anyway... Yes, the calamari clean out. The calamari clean out. Well, I did get some stuff cleaned out of my, I did clean out some of my crafting stuff. Like, I did go through the boxes and I made boxes of, like, stuff I use all the time and then boxes of stuff that I don't use. I very rarely use. So that way I would have, I did do that, but I don't know, you guys. Usually it comes together faster for me, but today it's just not. See, isn't that good that you can see it doesn't work for me either, so you don't feel like you're floundering in your own? You can say, oh, that didn't work for Shelly either. So there you go. Like, I really like this one that I did. I love this one. And I textured the back. Can you see it? And I'm going to put, I decided I'm going to write, I think I'm going to do some a word here, but I can't decide whether I want to paint it or whether I want to cut it up like a ransom note. We are never going to let the calamari go, Susan. How can we ever let the calamari go? Anyway, you guys are so funny. Okay, what did you say, Liz? You played hooky on Friday and you spent the day at a vintage store and thrift shopping, craft store? Woo! Good for you. That's awesome. Good for you, Liz. That's really great. I'm happy for you. What's really cool is if you let it dry, they become really stable. Look, I did the same tissue paper thing on the back, the one where you guys said it looked like stucco. And then I was just trying to decide whether I was going to stick it in the mail like this, because if I was going to stick it in the mail, then I was going to write, you know, my return address and then her address and then write on it. But it's definitely got a piece of pattern paper, tissue paper, you know, the dressmaking pattern paper, and then white just off-white craft paint and then some spray ink on it. Oh, Bet, you're so sweet. You're so sweet. I'm just sort of like in my own, like, I know what I want it to look like in my head, but I don't have the stuff in front of me that makes it look like that. Does anybody else get like that, or is that just me? Does anybody else, like, see it in their mind and then see it in your mind and then it doesn't, it's not that way? Susan, we love you. There is, like, and that calamari gave me the best laugh of my life, okay? It was, like, one of the best laughs I have had in a very long time, and I was so grateful for that. You have no idea. I needed that laugh. I needed it. I so needed it. I was like, I don't even know what even started that whole thing that we were, the silly KonMari thing. Can I tell you, you know, there are people that do that for a living. Girls, that would never be me, because I couldn't do it, even if I tried. I couldn't do it. I could want to do it, but I'm definitely not doing it. I mean, I can't get it together good enough to do it. Can't even do it for myself, and I try. I did go through my craft stuff, though, and I did, like, say, okay, what is the stuff that I love, like, but it changes for me. Does it change for you guys? Do you guys, like, go through periods where, like, I really love that, I love using that supply, and then you go back and you go, well, no, I'm not using that supply for a while. I don't know. You guys, I don't know nothing. I don't know anything. What do you guys writing? Liz, I'm glad you were hanging out with us working on your spreadsheets. You know, I really want you guys to work on what you want to work on. Just because I'm, like, here working on my... You know, sometimes I watch other people and I'm not working on anything they're working on. I just do my own thing. I'm, like, in my own... I'm in my own space of my own whatever it is. I should get out my stencils, but I don't know. Wait, you guys, I need a different one. I need to either start making a different one or work on a different one so that I can get it to a place that I like. That I like it. Okay. I'm liking an element of each one, but nothing comes next. Lynn, I'm glad you're feeling better. You had me so worried. I was really worried about you. Wait, Carla's writing, she knows that when she gets done with the birds, with these birds, it will be a while before I do more. Carla, they are fun. And I totally know what you're talking about. That's why I make them in spurts. Like, I can't, things get really gluey for me. And so, if I'm too gluey, I can't move forward without the, okay, I need something. I need something for this one. I like the way it's looking and I like the texture, but I need, before I, like, continue painting on it, and this one needs something too. I don't know. Maybe I'll do some stamping on this one. Maybe I will do some stamp amping. Fussy cutting from magazines, I love. Okay, I do. But I have to be in the mood for doing it. I can't make myself fussy cut. I can't. Do you guys know what I mean? You're fussy cutting for magazines right now? Serendipity flowers on it? Yeah, it needs something, but it needs like a next level. Like, it needs some markings, but I don't have a marking pen here. I don't think I even have a... It needs like... I don't know. I need some markings on it. Like, I need some markings on the whole thing. And then it needs like some stamping, I think, but I don't... And I don't have my grease pen over here. The kind of cool thing with mixed media, you guys, is there's no rules in it. I mean, just layer your stuff until you like it. And then, you know, the idea is that it's supposed to have depth and texture and be made of multiple things. So if you have rhinestones or bling or whatever and you want to put it on there, go for it. If you want to, maybe I'll put a big flower on there. Or if you want to, you know, the idea is it has to come from organically from you, and it should be what you enjoy putting on there. It shouldn't be, like, a have to. Do you know what I mean? To buy craft supplies too, I just don't use them all. It is easy to do in bed cutting stuff. It's also easy to do watching TV too, Lynn, if you like to watch TV. They make you happy, Scotty? Awesome. Okay, who's lurking out there? Who is lurking out there? Come on, you lurkers, say hi, say hey, say hey. I want a focal point on this one, and all I can see is an image, like a person image. Person image. These are my painted, these are usually what's underneath my, these are my, what do you want to call it, my Wine Spectator magazinos. I have a pile of them. I usually keep one underneath there and then I just peel it off after a while. This one has bottles on it. I don't know if I want bottles on my postcard. Hey guys, I'm failing at this one. I can't, nothing is coming. Alright, let me look through this magazine really quick. Maybe I'll find something. What do you guys, yes, lurkers. Hi, Jan. You did some house cleaning? You can come clean my house. My house needs it. It's in the middle of a, I'm in the middle of a reorganization or a calamari crisis, right? Who was it? Who said that I'm in a calamari crisis? I'm in a calamari crisis. I am in a calamari moment. I'm in a calamari Calamari. Calamari moment. Wait, there's no one that comes from here, but I like this. I want like some big, like a big focal piece there. You know what? We have a bunny and a dog and a cat, so I know all about the pet care. All about the pet care, girls. So tell me what is on your Tuesday. Who's gonna work on your who feels like working on your shabby chic journal with me on Tuesday? We're gonna do that. I'm gonna cut out this hula dancer from the magazine, from one of the magazines here, and let's see if she looks good there. Who feels like working on their shabby chic journal on Tuesday? You have five cats, Jan? That's awesome. Good for you. We only have one cat, and that's enough for us for right now. Maui has a terrible feral cat problem, and so we used to have a big feral cat colony, but eventually they stuff happens and they die and that sort of thing. So we just have one indoor cat right now, and that's good. Indoor outdoor cat. And we have one little dog, and we have a bunny. We have one little dog and a bunny, and that's what we have going on. So, it doesn't sound like I'm having as much fun, or is Jan's not having as much fun because she's cleaning her cat boxes. No, animal maintenance, you guys know, it's like a lot. It's like having kids, but I don't know, like, and it all falls on you, right, Jan? My animal maintenance falls on me too. So this morning I was animal maintenancing the bunny. I was cleaning up the bunny's stuff. They're actually not very messy, but it's still, you have to do it. She has hay, the bunny's a boy, and he has hay, and the hay gets everywhere, like seriously everywhere. You're trying to get ready to go to Maryland? Oh, awesome. That sounds like a fun. That sounds like a winner. Who else is going on vacation? Who else has got their vacation planned for themselves? Who else is going on vacation soon? Let me see if I'm gonna like her. Let me see if I'm gonna like the hula danza. I think that I love my pets, but it can be really it can be overwhelming sometimes. Okay, what are you guys thinking on the green one or on the red one? The green one or the burgundy one? I may need to spray her. I'm not gonna cut out between her arms. I probably should, but I'd have to find. I don't know where my X-Acto knife is. It does sound like fun, Jan. Good for you. Good for you. You sound like you're going to have so much fun. Good for you. What kind of projects are you going to work on in your workshop? I like it. Good for you. Let me put her on this one because it's less busy, but it still needs something else. Oh, I love Myrtle Beach, Carla. I used to go all the time to Myrtle Beach. Myrtle Beach is one of my favorite places to go. Favorite. Favorite. Good for you. Love Myrtle Beach. Love it. I think that's awesome. Good for you. I'm liking her on this one. I'm gonna put her on here. You're gonna get a. Who are you gonna see at the House of Blues, Carla? Carla's going to Myrtle Beach, and she's gonna go to the House of Blues. Who are you gonna see? I love Myrtle Beach. I think it's awesome. Awesome. Good for you. Well, I alcohol inked her a little bit, so she would be, so the white wouldn't be so stark. I took that Lindy's spray, Stardust sprays, and I put it on a towel and I wiped over the white so it wouldn't be, because it was kind of stark white. You're going to see Jamie Johnson? You're going to have so much fun. Good for you. I might want to put one of my mixed media flowers on there. I put them in this little thing. You'll have so much fun. You are going to have so much fun. So these are all the paper flowers that I made from Serendipity paper. And made flowers and butterflies and all kinds of stuff. And let me see if I have one that'll look good on here. What do you guys, you guys are going to have so much fun. I think that's so good. It's awesome. You're going to have a great time. You are going to have a brilliant time. What are you talking about, a pig on a spit? I'm missing all that part. I didn't see that part. Myrtle Beach has one of the most amazing, if you guys like to do, you know, you guys know I'm into meditation and that sort of thing, right? Myrtle Beach has a place that you can go where it's just so beautiful, and it's just, and it's right in downtown North Myrtle Beach. And it is 500 of pristine acres, and you can stay there for hardly nothing, and it's really beautiful. And I used to go all the time. I haven't been in years, obviously, because I live here. The last time I went was maybe four years ago, maybe. Okay, I'm liking it better. It needs a word, though. It needs something. It needs some more stuff on this side. I'm liking that one better. I don't put flowers in everything. It just happened to be I was on a flower tangent because of that Serendipity paper. That's all. I don't have any green butterflies. And I cut a bunch of butterflies, too, but that butterfly looked good there. Let's see. So Yes, it definitely needs aloha. You like my card? Thanks, Susan. You guys know me and my like ridiculous Zen process of like I have to re-look at it and re-look at it and then glue it again and then glue it again and then glue and glue and glue. It definitely needs aloha on it, but it needs something over here too. I don't know what though. I'll leave that one there for a minute, and this one I need to work on too. This one I may put some butterflies on, so I just have to decide which butterfly. That one's washed out. That one might be too. I might be able to do the edges of it. It definitely needs some aloha. You're right about that. You are right, Miss Suzanne. Miss Susan, Susan, Susan. It needs some aloha. Who else is lurking out there? Come on, chat up, you lurkers. We know you're out there. I can see you. I can see your lurking self out there. So say hi. Say hey. Say I'm lurking. And you don't have to be making what we're making. I mean, mine's sort of my Zen process of making my own personal Zen process of making, or maybe not Zen, of making mixed media postcards. Collage postcards or junk mail postcards. I mean, you can call it anything you want. You need a boat or windsurfer? Well, I don't have one around in front of me, but I'll have to, I could look for one. I'm just trying to color the edges of the butterfly so you see it more, so that when I glue it on there, there's like a more of a contrast. But it doesn't look like that was even any better. Somewhere I have a maca, or a pencil. I don't know, you guys. This is like making me a little bit frustrated. Maybe I'll use a blue ink. Let's grab a blue one. You guys, so who, if you didn't cook this today, and what else, who, some cooked and some didn't. I haven't cooked. I'm thinking I'm gonna cook something though, and something really good though, something better, something more than salad. Although I do love my salad, I want something more than that today. Did you guys used to grow up in families with, that had big family dinners? That had big Sunday dinners? I did. I grew up in a family that had big Sunday dinners. You know what? Maybe I can find another piece of my serendipity paper that I like better, and then I can cut out a piece, and then I won't be messing, futzing with all this. Chicken fried steak. Okay, I'm coming right over. I'm coming right over. I would like some chicken fried steak. Love some chicken fried steak there, Susan. Thank you. I want that. Okay, I found a piece I really like. Let me see if I can find the butterfly die if I had it close by. I love chicken fried steak. Chicken fried steak is awesome. I'm like all in for the chicken fried steak. I'm coming. I'm coming over for your chicken fried steak at your house. What do you mean I have to cook? I can't cook it. I'm not cooking here. I'm coming for chicken fried steak at your house. What do you mean? I thought you were inviting me to your house for chicken fried steak. I want chicken fried steak. I would love some chicken fried steak. Love it. So Tuesday we're going to work on our Shabby Chic journal. And then Friday we'll be back to Christmas in July. And if all of you guys have joined our Facebook group or haven't, go on over and join it so that you could possibly And then we're doing a weekly giveaway right now, and it's just a random.org giveaway, but it's a fun giveaway. And I'll send you some crafty supplies from my stash, some cool little crafty bits and supplies and stuff from my stuff, which I think you might like. Guys, I don't know what I did with the die. I had them right here and then I moved them. I was trying to, when the guy was coming to clean it, to work on the electric, I moved them. I had them here yesterday, but where did I put them? I can't even cut that butterfly out. Okay, so I'm going to definitely do a butterfly here, but I think I'm going to do a butterfly. I think it's going to be from this color palette, like right here. I think I'm going to take the butterfly from there and put it here. I think it's going to have a butterfly, and then I just need some words. I want some letters. I could look for the letters right now. I could do that. That is one thing I can do, is I can look for the letters while I'm looking for the butterfly. Hi, Deborah. Jan says she's into for everything, that, as long as she doesn't have to cook. You know what? There are some days when I really love cooking, and then there are other days when I just can't. I just cannot cook. And it has been so hot here that I haven't wanted to cook anything. I mean, it has been really, and it's been sort of, usually it's windy here, so there's usually like a really nice breeze. But lately there hasn't been a great breeze. Oh, I found the word aloha, so I could maybe this, it's not quite big enough for that postcard, but maybe, we'll see. Let's see. It's just been so, I mean, it's so stiflingly hot that the thought of getting into my kitchen and cooking is just like too much. It needs a bigger aloha, right? All right, let's see. It needs a bigger one. Needs a bigger one. So what does your week look like for those of you that are heading to work this week? I hope that you find some time in your day to feel like you're being creative and crafty. Oh, good. Jan, you and I are coming over to eat chicken fried steak. I'm ready. Can we please eat chicken fried steak? If I didn't have to cook it, I would be so there. I'm like, okay, this one's like too dark. But I like the word though. I like the fact that it says secret on it. There's a gray secret. I was looking for, I know what I want, and it's a common word here, but I can't find it. You guys ever come to Maui, the best, and you like sushi, the best sushi restaurant I think in Maui is housed in Lahaina. Lahaina's a town. Housed in Lahaina in the Kobe Steakhouse, and it's called Oku Sushi Bar. And it's very good. The food is very, very, very good. Probably the best sushi, and I've eaten sushi all over. And it's very reasonably priced and really amazing sushi. Just so fresh and so wonderful. You know, Kobe Steakhouse has been here on Maui 30 years. I think the sushi bar has been here in the same equal amount of time inside there. And it's just really, it's really cool. So I like that. The food's excellent there. like this word too. Okay, let me see if I can make these work. These are not quite the color palette I want, but when you're picking magazine words, you guess you don't really have a choice. Don't have a choice when you're picking magazine words. Ohana means family, so it's a this is gonna go on my I don't know which one it's gonna go on. I kind of like it on this one, but we'll see. You're off till Thursday, Terry? Good for you. That's awesome. That's a great work week. That is a great work week. So if you guys want to make along on Tuesday, we're going to be working on our Shabby Chic journal. Or bring whatever you'd like to work on. You know, we're going to be working on embellishments, tuck spots, and be discussing how we're going to bind it. Now, if you aren't making a Shabby Chic journal, but you just want to make a regular journal, it's a really good time to do that too. Just because we're making a Shabby Chic journal doesn't mean that you can't just work on any sort of junk journal that you're working on. Okay? So, you can do that. I love the word Ohana, and I like the fact that it has a turtle. But I need more than this. What am I going to do? Guys, I have it in my head, but I can't. It's not coming together like I like it. All right, I like those. Maybe I'll put it. It's too blue for that. I don't have one. I don't have another. I have other ones that are in process, but not that are. Anyway, so we're going to work on that. That's too blue for that. Is too dark. Okay, I don't like any of those words. What are you guys writing? I'm missing it. You're off till Thursday. Good for you. Good for you. Your husband loves to cook, Deborah? Oh, awesome. I think it's great. I would love that. Okay, this one needs a word, but it needs a bigger aloha. This aloha is too small. This aloha is too small. That one's a little, and it's too white, so I'll have to paint it. I was going to maybe paint Aloha here. And this one needs like a big flower. Like, I see a huge flower there. Maybe I could put the Aloha, but I have to have the big flower that I have to cut out. Maybe I need to make the Serendipity paper for it, because I can see what the colors I want. Maybe I can just paint it. I could do that, too. You guys, I'm at a standstill. I can't decide. I'm like not, usually I'm in a much more zen place and it falls together, but I mean, I'm liking the hula girl, but she needs some words too. She needs a word. And this one, this is just a good background so far, and I don't know what I'm going to put. I could put the secret on it. I could put the secret here. And then it needs something. It needs some images that I don't have. And then this one I wanted to put a butterfly here, but I'm not. It needs like, no, it needs different color butterflies than what I have. Like, I like this one with the blue, but it doesn't have enough blue in it. I guess it's good enough, but this one's kind of cool. The purpley one. I don't know. I'm at a standstill. Okay, chat with me. Hi, Sarita. How are you? Oh, you don't need to be sorry you fell asleep. Good for you. You need to sleep. I think that's awesome. I don't sleep enough either. It's Scotty's telling me when she's in this place I'm in, she gets her Posca pens out and draws on it. And yeah, I have all my, I have a bunch of paint pens and markers right here too. I'm just, usually it comes together much faster for me or much easier, so I don't even think about it. But today, for whatever reason, it's not. It be not doing it. But that's okay. I have three in process. I mean, this one's almost done. It just needs, I am going to draw on it a little, but it just needs, I was hoping to find, like, I don't know what word I was hoping to find, but I was hoping to find something that I really loved. I have these really cool little metallic pens, and I'll show them to you, and I actually really love these. I don't know if you guys have used them, but they're just these little Office Max metallic pens. I don't know, one of the kids got them for me, and I like them, and they color really well. And I like them. They just like have little metallic bits on them, and I like those. I do have Posca pens, and I do, but I like these metallic markers. I don't know why I like them so much, but I do. I like them. I don't know. Hi, Sherry. How are you? Oh, I'm so glad you were sleeping, Sarita. I don't sleep heavily, steadily either. I try. I mean, I make the good attempt, but I try. How many of you guys made your serendipity paper and made embellishments out of them yet? Did anybody besides me work on your serendipity paper embellishments and, you know, make a few paper clips out of them? I enjoy doing them. I enjoy it. It's sort of zen for me. If I cleaned off my desk, I might have some more. I might suddenly get a zen experience. I just see a big flower. Maybe I'll draw the flower there. Maybe that's a really good idea, Scotty. Maybe I'll draw the flower. I'm liking her. She just needs something. I don't know what, but I'm liking her. I'm liking her composition. And I'm liking the, I liked the composition of this one, and I did the back. I just have to decide if I'm gonna write on it or what I'm gonna do. The back of this one has just some book pages, so I could continue with the book page part on the back here and or paint it or something. It just depended upon if I was going to mail it or not. You're hot, Sherry. It's hot where you are. Yeah, it's hot here. It's really ridiculously hot. I don't know why it's so hot, but it is. It's unusual. Usually it doesn't get this, as hot as it is right now, it usually doesn't get this hot until like August. Well, my ladies, I want to give you guys a big hug. Thanks for hanging out with me. I'm sorry I'm not more inspiring today. I don't know what's going on with me. Oh, your niece is coming over to help you build up your die cuts again. Oh my gosh, that's awesome. Sarita, I hope you post some of your cards in our Facebook group. We would love to see them. Love to see them. I'm sorry, ladies. I'm not much more inspiring today. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's because I haven't had anything to eat today. It is like she's looking at something. You're right. Well, I may paint on her a little bit more. I just have to get... I have to go crawl in the garage and get the paints I want. I know the bucket they're in, but they're kind of far back in the back. I would love to see what you're making, Sarita. I think, you know, card making is such a unique and personal experience. It would be awesome to see what you're making. I would love that. Yeah, she is looking like she's looking at something, but I wanted to add some words here, and then I don't know if it needs anything else, but after I add the words, maybe some marks. My serendipity paper is inspiring. Well, you guys will be making some cool serendipity paper soon, too. You know, I'm into it. I made a bunch of it. I have a bunch. I also did a bunch of painted book pages. Do you guys do that, too, where you do painted book pages and that sort of thing? It's just so that I have a stash of stuff to use, you know? I need to go eat. I definitely probably do. Today, I have been up since really early, and it's just been, I can't even tell you, it's been sort of a ridiculous day. Yeah, definitely I need to eat. It's been sort of a ridiculous day. I have, well, hopefully, after I finish making these, I'm going to send them out to you guys in the group. So if you've joined our Facebook group, sign up for those random act of kindness, and I'll send every, it may take me a little while, but I'll definitely send, send everybody something. I agree, Sarita. A stash of your things is essential. So I made these painted papers. I can show them to you. I can show you some of them. I go in spurts of making painted papers. How many do people do that too? Okay. So I go in spurts of making painted papers. And in my painted papers, like what I have right here, let me see if I have them here before I even talk about them. Here's the painted papers that I have here. So I just started making painted papers. It was like I was working on a journal and I started making painted papers. And so I have this whole stash of painted papers. I have more than this, but this is just what I have here on my desk. And I just started using, this was a doily that I used as a, you know, a stencil. And this was a die cut that I had made out of a packaging, and I used it as a stencil. So I started making painted papers, and so that I would have something to draw from. Like, because I have all those book blocks from what you take apart your books. Right? So these are great to use in your mixed media work because you don't know when you're going to need them, and you can cut them up like I did. I was tearing them up and putting them in here. So for me, I enjoy I have my, you know, especially if the quality of the paper is good. Now, I don't know if I'm going to cut paint on the other side. Some of them are double-sided painted on. Some of them aren't, you know, or the paint runs through them. So, you know, you can use these in your junk journaling efforts, too, if you want. You know, you two pages in your junk journal and then write over them. But some sides are double painted. And some of it, you know, because I was painting them and laying them on top of each other, it went through. So, that's just a handful that I have here on my desk, but I made a ton a couple weeks ago. They're in my garage. And do you guys ever shop at a store like Old Navy? They throw away their hangers, which is completely wasteful, and don't get me started on that. But they'll give you a handful of them, or even probably as many as you want. And I always get the ones that have the clips on the bottom, like where you hang up skirts or pants on, and I put my pants from there. I put my... Hi, Brenda! We're glad you're here. We miss you. I love you, Brenda. You make me laugh. I love your energy and your humor. So if you get those clips, you know, the ones that hold the pants on, my fingers are so dirty, it's terrible, then you can hang your papers up to dry that way. That's what I do. So I have a bunch of hangers in my garage with paper hanging off of them. And I love that. So this needs like some stamping and some, I don't know. I think you're right. I think I need to eat something. I think that's where it is. I think I'm running low on blood sugar. You're not nuttier than a crazy squirrel. You're awesome. Brenda in the house. Bet you're so funny. So I'm just making junk mail postcards. So did this help any of you in your endeavors and making junk mail postcards? Now, you don't have to do them as out there as mine. I mean, mine, I like making mine like a collage piece of artwork. And then I think the back I will either what I'll do is I'll write on like another piece of paper and then tack it on, you know. I'll sign the bottom of my artwork, and then if I'm gonna, and then I think I'll put them in an envelope instead of mailing them straight out. But you could mail them straight out. You can mail these, put them in the post just as they are. Now, I haven't put any sealer on the top of mine. I don't necessarily like it because it sticks, but, you know, you could if you wanted to. Thanks, Anne. You're so sweet, Anne. So save your post, save your junk mail. We're also going to make some junk mail Christmas cards. For that, all you need is some paint. You need to pick a, if you want to do them like, what did you say? Yes, you can use your ugly, yes, you can absolutely, Scotty, you're absolutely right. So how many of you guys buy paper packs of scrapbooking paper and, or you have old scrapbooking paper, or you get it at a yard sale and it's ugly? This is a great way to use your old scrapbooking paper. Get it out, paint on top of it, and go for it. You know, paint on it, make it into postcards, mail it out. Make sure you guys sign up in our Happy Mail Random Act of Kindness. Put your addresses there in our Facebook group, Crafting Mamas, so that you can, so somebody can send you some random act of kindness, and eventually you'll get something from me. There's some crazy painted tag, or maybe a, yes, this is totally a pity pat pat thing. Oh my gosh, it was totally a pity pat. I'm just sort of like drawing a blank. Usually I come up, I have a vision. Like I want a big, I think I want a big flower here. But I think I'm going to have to paint it. I think I'm going to have to paint a hibiscus. So I just need to find, maybe I'll draw it with a Posca pen and then paint it. And then the back of it, I definitely need to do something to the back if I'm going to mail it out. If I'm going to just send it out as a piece of artwork, I don't need to, but Sarita says she's a paper addict and you love the ideas of using your ugly stash that you can't get rid of. It makes really good serendipity paper too, you guys. It really does. You know, when you start cutting out your cool stuff and, you know, it makes a really cool serendipity paper to make your embellishments out of. Like a patchwork quilt, right? Like it starts to look like a patchwork quilt. And then you're like, you're super happy with it because it looks good. You know, sometimes, I don't know why, does every paper pad you guys buy have ugly pages in it too? Mine does. I mean, I haven't bought scrapbook paper in a long time, but it definitely has some ugly pages going on in it. What did you say? Brenda says, if it's Christmas paper, it wouldn't be a high Christmas instead of a hibiscus. Oh, you're hilarious. If you guys saw the Christmas paper here, you guys, it has girls in whole skirts on it, okay? If you tried to buy, like, Christmas, like, of course you can go to big box store and get, like, regular Christmas paper with Rudolphs and snowmen, but I always try to buy, if I'm going to, especially when I'm going to send presents to people that don't live here, I try to buy the Hawaiian version of Christmas paper. It's actually very funny. Very funny, very sweet. You're funny, Brenda. I love that. You've got such a great sense of humor. So how many of you are making, are following along our Christmas and July series and are going to make on Friday with me? I think Friday what we're going to do is we could make our Christmas cards if you wanted, but I was thinking that maybe I'm going to show you guys how to make a, yes, it's 80% good and 20% unusable, right? So I'm thinking Friday we may make our fabric. We're going to make fabric and paper flower brooches. So you can make them out of paper and fabric. And you can use them as embellishments for your journals, too. If you don't want to use them and make them I don't know. I love scrapbook paper, but I don't spend a lot of money on it. So maybe the reason I get like not so great scrapbook paper is because I'm buying it like at a place like Tuesday morning. Like when I went to the mainland, I bought it at Tuesday morning or that sort of thing. So I didn't, you know what I mean? It wasn't like the brand new whatever just came out on Graphic 45. I got like the whatever was old Graphic 45. I mean, that's just what I buy. Just because, you know, I have to also bring it back home with me. And if I buy, I mean, you guys, quite honestly, I make my own stuff more times than not. Like, I'll make my own serendipity paper, or I'll just paint paper, or I do have some scrapbook paper, though. I don't use it so much anymore. I mean, I haven't. I make tags and tabs for my journals with it. I don't know. But I do like, I love good scrapbook paper. I love really good quality scrapbook paper. I think one of my favorite brands is a crepe paper brand. You guys know that one? I like Maggie Holmes as well, too. For the paper quality, not necessarily the paper patterns, but the paper quality. You guys know me. I collect books, specific books for the paper quality. Sarita says all paper is good paper. Jan, serendipity paper is this. It's where you take all your scraps of paper like this and you glue them down. These are pages that I've just made and used, but you can use, you found a Halloween card your grandmother made in 1940? Oh my God, I would think I would scan that and just use the scan. So, it's where you take all your bits and scraps, and then after you put them all together, then you stamp on them and paint on them and ink on them, and then you make really cool embellishments with them, or you use them for your background papers, or you cut out, you know, that's what these flowers were, the flowers that I put on this card. These flowers that I put on this card, this is like made from serendipity paper. So just give you a way to use up all the little tiny bits and pieces and scraps that you have. And you know, that's why I save all the little tiny things I've jelly printed on and all the little tiny things that I've made. That's what I do with them. Mr. Victor Crafter makes his paper, his scrapbooking paper out of napkins. That's awesome. I like him. Don't you guys like his videos? Have you been over there to watch him? Mr. Victor Crafter? I did not give it the name Serendipity Paper, Terry. When I first started paper crafting, I thought that that's what you had to do. Like, I was so naive that I thought that that's what, and then one day, a friend happened to come by, and she was a big paper crafter, and I was making some sort of like a scrapbooking embellishment. I was making a wedding book for a friend's daughter. And I was making, like, freehand cutting hearts and doves and stuff like that for it. And I was making it out of I had made this paper, the color of her wedding thing, right? And I had made my serendipity paper, the color of it. And I just thought it was just, like, one-of-a-kind paper is what I called it. And my friend came over and she was like, oh, that's awesome, you're making serendipity paper. And I said, oh, cool, I didn't know that's what it was called, you know? So, I have no idea where the name came from. I was just told that's what it was called. So, it could be called something completely different. You could call it scrap paper. You could use it, call it one-of-a-kind paper. You could call it junk paper. But I find that all of us crafty peeps that love, all of us that love paper crafting have tiny bits and scraps of things. Or I save my wrapping paper at Christmas time. Christmas cards, birthday cards, that sort of thing. And I cut it up and I make my own one-of-a-kind paper. I love Mr. Victor Crafter. Isn't he the nicest guy, you guys? And he's so sweet and he's so supportive. And he's just a nice guy. I like him a lot. So if you guys haven't watched his video on champagne flowers, I think I linked it in one of the videos I'd made a few weeks ago or last week or the week before, and it's really cool. He makes these flowers from the foil that comes on wine bottles and champagne bottles. I was thinking about going to ask a few of the bars around here, you know, because there's lots of bars in Maui. I was going to go see if I could ask one, at least at a hotel that, you know, serves champagne or that sort of thing, if I could have some. Hi, Fiona Jane. How are you? Make them postcards. Make them my mixed media postcards. Right now, I'm just going to cover them, covering the back with some patterning paper. You guys, go enter the giveaway. This week's giveaway is asking you to share your favorite YouTube channel. And I'm not telling you guys because I expect you to put my name down there, but that's not why. It's just, it's always fun to find one that you really love. And then, you know, but when somebody tells you about a new one that you don't know, it's like super cool. So go and join the giveaway. It'll be drawn on Friday in the middle of our live stream. Via random.org. Sorry, I got a glue booger on here, so it was making it difficult. I'm just going to cover the back with that pattern paper, the tissue paper, and then I may paint over it later, or maybe not, I don't know. Just so maybe if I wanted to write something on the back of it, I may not write on top of it, I may just glue some other paper down. So, Fiona, you didn't miss much. Today I'm kind of dragging. Today, I think it's because I didn't eat anything. Because I was going to do it much earlier, but then I got caught up in some personal stuff, which was silly. It was like, you know, like when you sit down and you say, I'm going to do this, and then my neighbor came by, and then it was like one of those things where we have every intention of starting early and had all my stuff, and then I got a phone call, and then... You know, that sort of thing. So, that is what. So, I didn't eat anything today either, so I think I'm just a little off because of that. I haven't had, and then we were talking about chicken fried steak, so that made it even better, right? I want some chicken fried steak. Susan, you're laughing, but one of these days I'm going to show up, I'm going to knock on your door. You're in Bette's door, I'm going to knock on your door and say, I want some chicken fried steak. I want some twice baked potatoes, or whatever you're cooking. Fiona, are you feeling better? I hope you are. Now, you guys, this is the same way you could do a journal cover, the exact same way. You don't have to be limited just because I've decided to do junk mail postcards. You don't have to be limited to my ridiculousness. You could do a junk journal cover this way if you were going to use an envelope or even a what do you want to call it? A cereal box. So Brenda, Susan saying, come, you'll be waiting. I'm coming. You wait. I will be there. Oh, Fiona, I hope you feel better. Brenda saying, what she's about to say before we sign off is that there's ugly paper in every pack because it's the only way they can get rid of it. Oh, good. You're good. Yes. Bette saying, Sarita, it's actually called Mr. Crafter Victor. I didn't know that. So, yeah, if you know, I've painted over. If you guys have a stencil, you don't really need a lot of supplies in order to make some really cool one-of-a-kind paper. Susan's saying it's called Mr. Victor. Now, is it called Mr. Crafter Victor, or is it called Mr. Victor Crafter? I thought it was Mr. Victor Crafter, and it has an eyeball on it. It's called Mr. Victor Crafter, and it has an eyeball on it. There you go, Sarita. So, you can use the same process with your journals, you know, and also the same process for your tags. If you want to make, like, really cool one-of-a-kind tags, you could do the same thing. You know, and if you wanted to cut them out by hand, what I would do is I would make your paper first and then lay your template down and cut it up. Oh, Fiona, I hope you feel better. You're not alone, sister. You have all of us in our crafty ridiculousness. You guys, thanks for everybody that joined the group, that's being so kind and generous with everyone. I'm really so grateful. Did you see the comment that somebody left about how, you know, she hasn't been a member very long, but it's a group she wants to be part of because everybody's so kind? And I appreciate that because, you know what, my artwork may not be in a great space today, but it'll be in a different space tomorrow. And, you know, same for all of you. But I'm grateful that you guys are kind to each other, especially in our group, you know? I'm grateful for that. I think that, you know, we all could use a little kindness. Oh my gosh. You guys are so funny. I'll bet you guys are great. So Tuesday, we're going to work on our Shabby Chic journal. We're going to continue. We're going to make some pockets and envelopes and embellish the pockets and envelopes that we already have and the tuck spots that we already have going. So bring whatever you want. Bring some ephemera that you want to add to your journal. Bring some flowers or cutouts or any sort of die cuts that you want to use. We're going to do that. And then on Tuesday... And if you aren't making a Shabby Chic journal, just bring your journal along. And if you haven't even started a journal, all you need is some pages. Just need some paper. Then on Friday, we're going to do, I think, I will make sure that I put the list out far enough advance for those of you that want to collect some supplies. I think what we're going to do is make a flower brooch. For like a lapel flower, and we can make it out of fabric, and we're going to make it out of paper. You could also use it as an embellishment for your journal, or you could use it as you could make it into a paper clip if you don't want to make it into a brooch. You could make it as a journaling charm that hangs off the back of your journal, but we're going to do it in both fabric and we're going to do it in both paper. And maybe... Oh, Jan, we're happy you came and lurked with us. I'm sorry I'm not. Usually I have much more energy. Today I'm just a little fading. We're going to do that on Friday. And then the following week we will be doing your hardbound book, the one that has a spine of 2 inches and a half a yard of fabric. And I'll tell you if there's any, that'll be the next week. Oh, Fiona Jane, I'm sorry. Oh, no. Sending you hugs. Oh, thanks, Jan. I appreciate it. I really appreciate it. You girls are my crafty peeps. I love you girls. I have to agree with Bet. It's better if you just hang out with people that are chatting and talking about craft. Remember my beautiful friend Renee? She says craft or cry, right? So you can craft and cry. I do that sometimes. I totally do that sometimes. I craft and cry. Do you guys ever craft and cry? Jan, I hope you come back. We're on every Tuesday and Friday for definite. Sunday sometimes. Tuesday and Friday, and I usually start at 9 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Today I started a little bit earlier. Yeah, Sarita, I agree with you. I totally, totally agree with you. I absolutely agree with you. If you guys haven't gone over and checked out Carla at Caged Fish, you'll really love her as well. You should go and check her YouTube channel out. She's really cool. I really like her a lot, and she's a very giving, kind artist. She's a very giving, kind artist. Drop in anytime, Jan. Drop in even if it's for a minute or two. You know? Sometimes people come and just say, hey, and then, you know, we don't see them again for a while. And that's all good. One time or a lot of times. Doesn't even matter. I'm going to go find my Word folder, and I'm going to find my Posca pens, as Scotty said. I definitely could use those. Okay, my lovely ladies. Especially you, Fiona Jane. Fiona Jane, I do the same thing sometimes, and especially when I'm stressed, I'll just clean. The only problem with me is sometimes I start throwing stuff away and then I regret it later. Okay, ladies, close your eyes for a second. Especially you, Fiona Jane. Ready? Breathe in. Inhale. And exhale. And as always, from my heart to your heart, I'm sending you so, so, so much aloha. You guys can head over to Facebook and check each other out and continue to chat. I know the chat stays live for as long as you guys want to chat. I don't think it cuts out. I don't think it does. I think it will, as long as you're chatting with each other, it'll chat here. It doesn't save the chat, so you don't have to worry that somebody will read something you've written if you don't want them to. All right, my best friends, my crafty peeps, my loves. I love you guys so, so, so much. And, yep, I'm going to go make myself. I'm going to make myself something. It's not going to be chicken fried steak, but I'm going to make myself something. All right, my friends. I am so happy that you came to hang out with me. And stay tuned into the Facebook group so that you can see some of my ridiculous postcards. I'll try to finish them in the next day or so. All right, big hugs. Aloha.